in the Tamil Nadu Assembly. Will it take place or not? That remains the big question, because remember, the Assembly has been adjourned for the second time, and now the reconvening time will be 3 p.m. today. Well, the drama, of course, continuing in the Tamil Nadu Assembly. I want to quickly go across to Priyamvada, who, of course, has been getting us minute-to-minute updates of what's transpiring on the floor of the Assembly, but we seem to have lost her. We'll just reconnect with her. So let's go back to Lokpriya and Vaishnavi. Lokpriya and Vaishnavi, the drama continuing there. What are you picking up?
Well, that's right. In fact, now the assembly session will start at resume at 3 p.m. But we can see we have already seen so much drama since morning. Let me take that question to Lokpriya. Lokpriya, what all did we see throughout the day, and what do we really expect now after 3 p.m.?
Well, that's correct. We have seen the pandemonium in the assembly premises. It has been adjourned twice. The DMK, the opposition, and Opaniselvam camp have been demanding for a secret ballot, and they have been asking for a postponement of this entire vote of confidence. They say that the MLAs need to go to their constituency and then come back. When the governor has given a time till 15 days, why should the vote of confidence take place in such a hurry? That is the argument coming in from the DMK and Paneerselvam's camp. There has been violence that was witnessed in the first session between 11 to 12:15. There was violence. We saw mics and chairs being thrown, books and documents being thrown. So that was the pandemonium that we witnessed. And then later when the session resumed at about 1 p.m., the speaker spoke about the kind of humiliation and the kind of treatment that was meted to him. He talked about how the DMK was involved in all these ruckus, and he asked the DMK to be evicted from the house. But MK Stalin and other MLAs, they stayed put and they refused to leave the assembly. They say that there is only two options. You either have a secret ballot or you ensure that the vote of confidence takes place on some other day. So the house has been again adjourned because they were not able to conduct any business. So the house will now...
Because we are being joined now by Majid Memon of the NCP and, of course, senior jurist on the phone line as well. Majid Memon, what do you make of the entire morning's proceedings in the Tamil Nadu Assembly? Absolutely shocking, sir. The kind of ruckus that was witnessed, unprecedented scenes.
See, Tamil Nadu is rated as a state which has a high rate of literacy, and therefore the behavior of the people's representatives in Tamil Nadu is not accepted what we have been seeing from morning 11 o'clock onwards. I'm sorry to find that DMK, which is trying to instigate the rebellion from AIADMK, which are hardly a few handful MLAs headed by OPs, is trying to disrupt the proceedings, dishonoring the speaker's authority, and resorting to a disorderly conduct on the floor of the house by throwing chairs and papers and all that. It's very distressing and unfortunate that people who are supposed to lead the people of Tamil Nadu are misleading them to the extent that they have no respect for the legislature, for the August House, where they are conducting, all these kinds of activities. I'm sorry to see this scene, and I should only appeal to Karunanidhi and his daughter Kanimui and the leaders of DMK to prevail upon the MLAs from their party to resist from this kind of misdemeanor on the floor of the house.
Yes, Mr. Memon, because the fact is, even if the government survives or not, will it be stable? Will this be the way they would have wanted to pass a floor test? I mean, what's really happening? Is this what the voters have voted for in the first place?
The DMK, I don't think, need to be told these basic things of our Indian democracy. That let the show of strength as required under the Constitution today be performed. Even if you lose, you can become a strong opposition and you can pull up the government as and when situation comes. If it is not very stable or if it is not representing the will of people of Tamil Nadu, then definitely you can adopt other lawful means, orderly behavior, orderly means by which you can compel the government to step down. But this is not the way. This violent method of not permitting the functioning of the house as ordered by the Honorable Governor and as required under the Constitution, as required by the Supreme Court verdicts. And then you are obstructing the fate, which is a fate accompany. It's obvious. It's obvious that the present Chief Minister enjoys majority and you want to just defer it or avoid it by means which are absolutely unethical, improper and violent. You know, is only bringing disrepute to you and causing further damage to your reputation. So I don't think people of Tamil Nadu would appreciate or approve the conduct of their representative, the people whom they have chosen, the DMK MLAs. And DMK High Command must also give a second thought to send a important message immediately to their members in the House that they should behave in an orderly manner.
The DMK High Command must intervene, says Majid Memon. Thank you, Mr. Memon, for joining us there and, of course, giving us your first reaction of what's really transpired in the assembly today. Well, let's quickly go back to Lokpriya and Vaishnavi. Lokpriya and Vaishnavi, of course, the DMK protests, they're continuing on the floor of the House. Will marshals have to now be brought in to, evict them from the floor of the House? How will the assembly reconvene at 3 p.m. if these MLAs will refuse to budge?
Well, Uday, so far at least the DMK MLAs are inside the house and they are holding a dharna. They are saying that they are not going to move out of the house. But it is up to the speaker's now call as to, you know, whether he is going to call in the police and evict these MLAs. But Lokpriya, if you can tell us as to what do we expect now, because the DMK MLAs are very adamant. They say that they are not going to move out of the house. So what exactly will happen next now? Will the speaker... is it up to the speaker to call for the police and evict, or do we expect that even now?
Well, that's correct. The big question really is, if the DMK MLAs are not evicting from their house by themselves, what then happens?
Yeah.
Will the speaker call assistance? Will they call guards to remove them forcefully? Remains to be seen. But just let's take you across to what's happening outside the secretariat. This is the view outside the secretariat. All roads leading to secretariat have been blocked. There is no vehicle movement and there is police presence. It has been stepped up. Around 2,000 police personnel are there in and around Fort St. George, in and around the secretariat to ensure there is no untoward incident.
Yeah.
No vehicles allowed. The road is completely free, as you can see.
So a lot of movement inside the Tamil Nadu Assembly, but no movement outside the Tamil Nadu Assembly because the roads have been sealed. Unprecedented security deployment there. If you want to, go in that vicinity of the area, we advise, of course, you don't take those roads, as our correspondents there were showing you. Absolute roads, chock-a-block jam there, of course. And all roads have been sealed leading to the assembly premises. So the drama continues. Remember, 3 p.m. is when we're expecting the House to reconvene. Our reporters are with us live. Don't go anywhere. Our continuous coverage continuing after this break.